My name is Calliope, and I am a student at Green's Academy of Spirituality and Metaphysics, or CASM. Today we are conducting a study. Let's see, what am I supposed to read here? So, in exchange for a free extended treatment, we are testing different crystals and percussion tools for our piezoelectripuncture treatment, or PEP. So with piezoelectripuncture, we are creating these little spikes of energy that help unblock and clear your energy, works as an energy healing modality. So we are going to be striking a carefully selected crystal. I have quite a few in here with a percussion tool. Now our original is right here. This is a modified Tromner neurological reflex hammer. So we would be taking the crystal, putting it on different points based on Chinese acupuncture of the traditional Chinese medicine. So for example, maybe we put it right here between the eyebrows, take the crystal, and tap on it a specific number of times with the hammer. I have quite a few different hammers to choose from. So, we have the Tromner. We have a buck hammer. Or rather, this is a Taylor hammer. This is a buck hammer. Taylor or tomahawk hammer here. The buck hammer. A queen's square, right here, one of my favorites. And a Babinski hammer. Don't see this one too often. As for crystals, back. So we are primarily working in the agate family here. Got another one right here. But I do have a carnelian. Five hammers, and there is a randomized order in which I'm supposed to use these. Every student gets a different order. So, let me see, are there any contraindications here? No. Was there anything specific you wanted to work on with this? Anything you feel that is blocking your energy? Okay. I'll just focus on an all-over treatment. So, do I have permission from you to to look at and manipulate your energy field. Wonderful. So I'm going to take a peek. I'm just going to take a peek. Getting a feel for the barriers as well as the texture. I'm taking some of it in my hands and rolling it across my skin. Good. We're looking at outer boundaries. Samples just to make sure that let's see if I can get a bit that wants to come out here. Snip. Good. I just want to make sure it's conducive to the crystals that I'm working. Anybody want to come out of here? Maybe right in here. Snip. Sealing the elasticity. Like testing bread dough. You're doing the window pane test where you stretch the dough and you should be able to get some translucency without it breaking. And then see if we can get a couple from the outer edges. Bigger glob, if you will. Good. And one more thing. Thank you. going to tease out the edges so that I can see what changes are occurring. Make it a little more visible. Good. Let's get started. I think let's go with carnelian and drumner. And there is a specific protocol that I am supposed to follow here. It can vary from person to person, but because we're testing the tools and the crystals, the set protocol. So we are going to start with your face and head. I'm going to take the carnelian first, and we're going to start at the third eye. Do you mind if I touch you here? I'll just mostly be using my fingers to stabilize. Just like that. Good. Above the other eyebrow. The outer corners of the eyes. Above the lip here. Very carefully. Good. A divot above the chin. And the crown of the head. Just want to check the energy in the back. I could use just a little bit of this. Here we go. And let's go ahead and do the left cubital fossa. So this is the crook of the elbow. Around the wrist crease here on the radial side of the arm. Good. Center of the palm. And the pad of the thumb. Other side. We'll do the cubital fossa here. Okay. Good. And then the first joint of the thumb. The superior clavicle and inferior clavicle points. This is going to be 3 each. Good. Inferior. Right. So I am going to have you turn around for me. I can get the back of your body. I'm going to have you let your head fall forward so that I can get the occiput points. Right. I'll give you just a second. Occiput, spine, lower back. There we go. Alright, so back of the head, either side of the occiput. Now we'll do either side of the spine. everything here before we get into the low back. And then we'll work from the feet upwards. Lower back here. Good. All right. Now I'm going to do a couple on the top of each foot. And below the knees as well. So inferior to the knee. I could just have you come back around. Here we go. So that was our first round. How did that feel? Do you feel any sort of shift at all? Just going to take a peek at everything while I listen to what you have to say. Okay. Let's just tease everything out a little bit. Before we go back for some more. Just want to make sure everything stays visible. Above the eyebrows. Outer corners of the eyes. Then we'll get into the hands and arms. So if I could see the crook of your elbow here. joint. And the pad of your thumb. I could have you turn around. There you go. I'll do the occiput here. And the spine. Inferior and superior to the patella. Back of the knee. And the hips here. So any difference with the agate and the tailor hammer? Any particular difference you noticed? We'll just move right along then. Let's go ahead and do clean square. Good. Okay, I have a flip here. We're able to be a little more snappy. it. In the hand. Fossa. Good, and then joint. Going around back. Side. The knees. Good. Backs of the knees. Let me just see. Dubinsky hammer here. And let's do, I think maybe this particular banded agate here. Joint. Crease here. Center of the palm. Good. Excellent. Good. And we'll go to the foot. Everything looks good here, and I have to say, since we're doing this rather extended treatment, your aura is like a placid lake. So calm. No ripples. Lastly, we will have the banded agate here and the buck hammer. So, we're going this nice and slow, since this is our final iteration here. Now we will do right between the eyebrows here. Good. Above each eyebrow. Of the lip here. Divot above the chin. The cubital fossa on the right side. And then the first joint, the most proximal, in the thumb. The wrist crease, radial side. And the center of the palm. Center of the palm. Good. And then we will get into the clavicles on the occiput. So, above the clavicle. Down each side of the back. Above and below each knee. The back of the knee. Two places. Good. down two positions on each hip. There we go. Let's see what we've got. Or it can tell me quite a bit, but I would love to hear your particular experience. So I'm gonna take some samples here and just make sure. Right there. Good elasticity. Just trying to feel for anything that is all right and coming loose. There we go. Bigger sample right here. Texture, elasticity, good. One more. The end of our extended piezoelectripuncture experiment, if you will. I hope that that makes your energy, makes your mood and motivation, that it clears all of that out and you feel refreshed and accelerated and invigorated. All those little I hope you have a whale of a day and a good rest of your night. Thank you. Bye now. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video, it would greatly help me out if you clicked the like button and left a comment so YouTube's algorithm registers that it was a good video. If you want to see more of my work, consider subscribing to the channel. I create primarily medical, pseudoscience / alternative medicine, and personal attention ASMR roleplays. But I've done a little bit of everything, from historical
list for props and equipment. Thank you again, and I hope you have a whale of a day and a good rest of your night.